discussed at length, and it has created a lot of curiosity amongst us on what's the learning going to be every Wednesday. Indeed, this is an initiative from divisions B, M, and S, and I'm sure all of you are excited to attend this session as well. We thank you all for joining in. This is the prime time. I think we all should applaud each other for not watching those news channels and those rumblings around which goes during 9 to 10 p.m. Instead, we are here peacefully sitting to learn something quite interesting for all of us. We have with us a gentleman who is a Toastmaster since 7 years. He is a cost accountant and a SAP practitioner. He is retired and he was the winner of the district level to table topic contest in the year 2018. He is an ardent TL ACL completed person. He has also finished a pathway. And I vividly remember during those good old days when we had those physical meetings, I had the pleasure and the opportunity to shake hands with him. And it is he who taught me how to log into pathways. My memories are still fresh. Let's put our hands together to welcome Toastmaster Subbu, who is famously called with this name. Over to you, Subbu.
Yes. Thank you, Toastmaster Vivek. It was very kind of you for having introduced me. Good evening, everyone. First of all, am I audible and visible to all of you? Fine. First of all, I thank the organizers for having given me this opportunity to conduct this table topic session. Recently, I conducted this session twice, once for Kargar Toastmasters and one for Thane Toastmasters. Some of you who might have attended this meeting might felt this kind of repetition. Do we have any timer for today?
I can double up as a timer, Subbu.
Yes. Okay. Vivek, I will divide this session into three parts. The first part is a theoretical overview of maximum 15 minutes. The second part will be a practical demonstration of table topics. Okay, I will give some topics and I will invite some speakers. I will also give feedback simultaneously. Okay, the table topics practical and the feedback session will be conducted simultaneously, and that will be for another 30 minutes. So 30 plus 15, 45 minutes we have it. Is it fine?
Absolutely. At 12th minute, I will show a green card.
Yes. So from now onwards, the 12th minute, show me a green card, and 13th yellow, and 15th red. Fine? Fine. So good evening, everyone. We have 22 participants. You know, I know there are some mix of fresh Toastmasters, some experienced Toastmasters, and some veterans. I just wanted to know from you, you can just put your feedback in the chat messages. What is your understanding of table topics? What you mean by table topics? I'll just give you 40 seconds. You can just type in the chat boxes. Let me see any feedback coming. This is going to be an interactive session. There is no PPT, nothing. Straight, only simple fundamentals. Anyone? Talk on the spot, very nice. Monish, you are absolutely right. Anything else? Impromptu speech, fine, instant thinking, absolutely right. All of you got it. Let me tell you the fundamental differences between a normal speech and a table topic speech. A table topic speech is an impromptu speech where the speaker has to speak on the spot. You are right. Either the contest master or the Toastmaster of the day will give you a subject. In a normal speech, we know the subject in advance, number one. Number two is the duration of the speech. A normal speech may be around 5 to 7 minutes. Sometimes it can be 10 to 12, and sometimes speeches are short, maybe 3 to 4 minutes, depending upon the project. But a table topic is absolutely a very small duration, maximum 1 to 2 minutes or 2.5 minutes. Second, third thing is table topic speeches or universals. They are not restricted to any particular type of audience, or it doesn't follow any particular pattern. Let me tell you what are the commonalities between a normal speech and a table topic speech. A normal speech must have 3 S. What I call 3 S is, I'm hearing some background noise. Can I request some of you to just switch off the audio?
Can everybody go on mute, please? Yeah, yes. Thank you.
Yes. If you want to raise any questions, raise your hand. You can just put in the chat box and then you can ask me. A normal speech must have 3 S. The same thing is applicable for table topics as well. One is specific point. What is the specific purpose of a speech? Be it a normal speech or even a table topic speech, there should be a specific purpose, a point. In a table topic speech, once the table master, the contestant gives you a subject, you have to take a stand on it. You need to respond to the subject. You can either speak for the subject or against the subject. That is up to you. But there should be a very clear-cut stand, a clear-cut observation, a clear-cut response. That's what I call a specific point. Number two, it must have a structure. What differentiates a table topic speech and a rambling is that in a table topic speech, we follow a very clear structure. Again, there should be an opening, a body, and a conclusion. The opening may have one or two lines and the closing may have one or two lines. It doesn't matter. But there should be three essential parts in table topic speech. That is the second S. The third S is supporting materials. Any speech must have supporting materials like stories, incidents, anecdotes, quotes, anything. These are all supporting materials. The table topic speech must have these supporting materials. Remember, whenever you go on the stage, either in a club level or in a contest level, these three points are absolute must for any table topic speech. Is that clear to all of you? If you have any questions or any point of clarification, just put a message in the chat box, or Vivek can just repeat back to me.
Yeah.
This is the definition of your table topic speech. Now, the next question is, is it possible for us to prepare for a table topics? I just wanted to know some feedback from some of the participants. Is it really possible to prepare for a table topics speech?
Devo, Toastmaster.
Yes, Monish says yes. Okay, fine. Anybody else? Maybe on subject, just relate instantly. Very good. Okay. Yes, Kritika, you're right. Any other feedback? Fine. Okay. I think that should be enough. Let me tell you. Yes, somebody wanted to speak. Somebody wanted to share his observation.
Monish, you want to share anything?
No, I didn't. I joined just now.
Fine. Okay. You see, when I said a table topics must have three elements, I said structure, specific point, and supporting materials. We always can have supporting materials in advance. You might ask me how. See, I was a table topics for, I was in Toastmaster for 7 years. First 3-4 years, I was a newcomer, novice. I attended various club meetings, contests. I couldn't get hold of it, you know. I couldn't understand how these speeches were given, how the topics were selected. What I did in one particular year, I attended all the contests right from club level up to district level. I noted down in a notebook what are the various subjects asked in that particular year. That was in 2017. Then I came to know what is the syllabus of Toastmasters. The syllabus of contest is, they will not give you a subject on, say, on radioactivity or gravitational physics or astronomy. The subjects given to you will be related to your day-to-day human values. Truth, honesty, hard work, success, failure, love, fear, opportunity, adversity, challenges. These are all the fundamental life attributes. Your syllabus is all these topics. The text may be different, the phrase may be different, the idiom may be different, but the subject matter is going to fall in this category. Am I right? Most of the veteran Toastmaster will agree. There could be occasional exception where the subject is slightly different. It doesn't matter to you. So what I did, let me share my experience, how I prepared for my contest in 2018. I worked for 15 days. I noted down all my personal stories right from my birth, during my childhood, school days, college days, corporate days, my personal life, with my friendship, everything I noted down. And I classified them. If there is a subject and honesty, what would I say? If there is a subject and truth, what would I say? If there is a subject and hard work, what would I say? I classified them. See, it's easy. If you dig your own story, you can usually bring the stories on the spot. What happens in a table topics session or any contest, your brain goes blank for this 10, 15 seconds. Once a subject is given to you, then you start thinking what to say. Your brain does not come to your rescue. That is because we have not trained our brain to think that way, right? Your brain will come to you if you have trained your brain. So my suggestion is for all those new Toastmasters, attend those various club levels, club sessions, area contests, understand how the speeches are delivered and have some ready-made stuff with you. Do not go on the stage blank. That means you are taking a lottery. Okay, whether you win it or it doesn't matter, but try to give your best. When I go for a contest, the idea is not to win the contest. The idea is to make an improvement as compared to my previous performance. Even if you improve by 10 centimeters, you might have done the best. That is how you prepare it. Okay. This is the file which I prepared. It has got 150 stories in my brain ready-made. Around 15-20 stories related to my personal life. And all other stories can be from your personal life or it can be your famous characters. For instance, see, we all have famous heroes for our life. You can be a Bollywood hero like Amitabh Bachchan or Shah Rukh Khan, or it could be a sportsman like Tendulkar, anybody. Just to give you an example, if there had been subject on practice, I would have spoken about Michael Jordan. If there is a subject on innovation, Steve Jobs. If there is a subject about success, failure, J.K. Rowling. That is how I went to any stage. Okay, you have ready-made capsules. You just have to synchronize the subject and fit into it. This is how you prepare for table topics in advance. At least for Toastmasters, right? Once you train your brain this way, let anybody give you any topic, your brain will come to your rescue and it will help you with the relevant supporting materials. Is that point clear to all of you? Any questions at this stage?
Yeah, I've got questions.
Yes.
Just can you list out your subject, what you have just said? We have said 8 to 10 subjects. Can you list out? I could not write out.
No, I just gave you examples.
Example is different matter, but subject matter. Subject 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
See, I'll just repeat it, whatever I said, okay? Honesty, truth, love, failure, success, disappointment, adversity, opportunity, any human values, what you face on a day-to-day
basis. Okay, that means we define and come to the conclusion.
Yes, okay. See, any human values. Okay, for instance, in one, I just attended the area contest in the current season. The subject was kindness is free. Kindness is your human value. I attended one more contest. Honesty the best policy? Honesty is a human virtue. Got it? So any subject following the normal human values, what you call it, that's going to be a subject matter. That could be a rare exception. It doesn't matter. But once you have a strategy, once you have your organizing skill, you can speak on any subject. That is how my understanding, that is how I prepared it. I'm not a table topic guru, but I cracked this, what I call it, this formula. And I'm sharing the formula.
I agree fully. We wanted to crack point of view. We have just understood your point.
Okay. The second thing is, what you should do is, Once you understood the subjects, you know, you have to take part in all the table topic session at a club level, practice as much as possible. Okay, knowing the formula is not enough. Practice. You will not believe it. I have witnessed at least 100 videos on YouTube. Okay, there are a lot of videos in YouTube on Toastmasters of various divisions, even of international contests, etc. Just go through it, take the subject, and just practice what would have been your response on it. Practice it. Practice makes you perfect. There's no other way. Okay, straight away, you cannot go on the contest day and try to give a subject. The harder you practice, the more polished you will become. That's the only recommendation. And when you take part in any, be it a club level or at even the contest level, do not bother about the outcome. Do not bother about whether you are going to win the prize or not. Do not bother about your position also. Just see, have you improved by 1 millimeter? Once you have that perception, you know, automatically you will improve and you will be surprised to see that you are outtaken others. That is my mantra. And this is what you can do in advance. And on the date of the contest or on the date when you attend your table topic session at your club level, what you need to do is once the subject is given, you know, do not start speaking immediately. Just reflect at least for 10 to 15 seconds. What are you going to say? What is going to be your stand? What is going to be your structure? The most important thing is opening. What is going to be your opening statement? Just reflect on it. Which supporting story are you going to use it? Think for 10, 15 seconds and then go ahead. Then listen, the most important point again, listen to the table topic subject. I attended a contest in Pune in 2018, okay? The contest chair of that day gave a subject which nobody could understand. Neither the participants, nor the judges, nor the audience, nobody could get it. But still some eight participants spoke on the subject and one of them was declared a winner also. Okay, the most important thing is you should know what is the subject. Even in a division contest, a veteran Toastmaster spoke very well, but he spoke on a subject which was not given to him. It is absolutely essential that you listen to the subject with 200% concentration. This is 50% of your job is over. And the third suggestion which I can share with you is keep calm. Do not panic. Okay, when you go on the stage, do not give a look as if your deer is caught in front of a headlight. You see, don't give that blank look. Just smile, talk as if you are talking to a friend. Absolutely, it's enough. The rest will fall into pieces. Yes, you will have butterflies in your stomach. Yes, you will have nervousness. That comes to every speaker, including the presidents, the prime ministers, everyone. But what matters is what is the strategy to overcome it. What I do, before I go on the stage for 10 minutes, I recite Sanskrit mantras so that I am focused on only on one thing. I cut off from the outside world. Do not look to your phone. Do not talk on other subjects. Just train your brain to be absolutely calm and quiet. It will help you. It will be a miracle. How many minutes more we have? I think 10 minutes or 15 is over, right?
Yeah. Can you see my red signal? It's over.
Yeah, I just saw it now. Okay. I don't want to stop it abruptly. If there are any valid questions, I can take it now.
Subrat, this is Subodh.
Yes.
I had a question. So you mentioned that, you know, when the topic is given to you, you wait for 10 to 15 seconds.
Yes.
But like, is there any rule in the contest that, you know, can we wait for that long? 10 to 15 seconds.
Listen, there are no hard and fast rules. Okay. The timer will start the moment you start speaking or give any action. Okay. So 10 to 15 seconds is reasonable. But if you wait longer, you cannot wait for 45 seconds because of the speech itself is for 1 minute, right? So it has to be very, very, it has to be, I mean, there is no hard and fast rule, but you can check up with experienced veterans. I believe 5 to 10 seconds is more than enough.
Yeah, okay. Thank you.
I have a question.
Yes.
Once I attended a meeting in Pune, and they gave me through the table topic to me, deja vu. I didn't know the meaning of that. So what at that time I should reply? Sometimes they give such a tough table topic. Deja vu, I do not know the meaning, to be honest with you.
Yeah, it's a very good question. You see, what I have noticed is there are three types of topics in table topics. One is what I call a level one topic, where the topic is very clear, where you know the subject and the supporting story is also given to you. For example, who is your favorite Bollywood hero? See, here the subject and is clear, you also know your supporting point. You don't have to rankle your brain to find out what to say, right? What is your favorite holiday destination? This subject is very clear. You don't have to search in your brain. Is it? You know what to speak. Supporting it is also given to you. That's called a level one. Level two subjects are some where the subject matter is clear to you, but you don't know about the supporting point. What story to tell on that subject? For instance, kindness is free. See, you know the meaning. The topic is obvious to you, but you do not know which story to repeat. Is it clear to you? The third type is what I call the advanced level, type three, I call it, where the subject is not known to you and you do not know the supporting materials. Sometimes such topics are given in contest level. To give an example, I think some audio is switched on, you know, I'm going to hear background noise.
I'll check.
Jayant Singh.
The third type of topic is where you do not know the subject and you do not know the supporting materials. For instance, in GTM, they asked, action, lights, camera. See, it doesn't have any meaning, but still you are supposed to talk on it. What you should do in those cases is you interpret your subject in your own way, make it clear to the audience, the judges, and then speak on it. Is that fine?
Third one, I didn't understand, to be honest with you. Action, lights, camera.
See, that is a simple phrase which is normally used in your Bollywood shooting, right? The director shouts, and then immediately the film shooting starts. In a table topics, if it is given to me, what I would say is, in life, you should be prepared for the right moment. A moment when you will be tested. A moment when you have to speak with full valor and ferocity. Okay, that means you should be prepared for the right moment. That is called light, action, and camera. That is how we'll interpret it. See, the interpretation is up to you. There is no hard and fast rule. There is no right or wrong. But you have to make it clear to the judges and the audience. Done?
So, Subbu, just to extend what Munish was asking, suppose if I don't get, say, deja vu is not at all English. However, okay, it becomes a colloquial slang which is used. So, somebody tells me rendezvous and I don't know the meaning at all of that particular word, then how do I go in front and do it?
See, if you do not know, you attach your interpretation. When you say deja vu means something it is happening again. It's a repetition, right? Deja vu experience means the same experience which you had in the past is happening again. Just give some meaning to it. Do not be blank. You have to speak 1 minute the subject. Even if you speak, it may not be particularly valid. See, nobody is going to validate it, whether right or wrong. People are going to tell how you are speaking. Got my point?
Absolutely.
Okay, I think, shall we proceed for the practical part now?
Yeah.
Okay, Vivek, do you have a list of speakers? How do we go about it now? I have some subjects, but how are you going to invite the speakers?
So, can we open the house for volunteers?
Yes, I would go.
All right. So I think we have Munish and followed by others. Just an announcement for all of you. The speaking time would be 1 to 2 minutes. So please make a note of my screen. You can either pin it or you can view at me. And my background will change. So when you start the speech, you will have a start button. And when you reach 1 minute, you will have a green signal. 1 minute, 30 seconds, you will have an orange signal. And 2 minutes, you will have a red signal, which will have an upper limit of 2 minutes and 30 seconds. So, can we start, Subbu?
1 minute, Vivek. I have one request. Whosoever is coming, the speaker, you know, just tell your name and just tell you a length of experience in Toastmasters. Accordingly, I'll give you a subject to you. The idea is, if you're a newcomer to Toastmasters, I'll give you a very simple subject. But if you're a veteran having participated in contests, I'll give you a difficult subject. You understood? Just tell your name and a length of experience in Toastmasters. Yes, Vivek, you can go ahead.
Yeah, Mr. Munish.
Give me any topic of your choice, sir.
How many years you have spent in Toastmasters?
Sir, I spent only 4 months, but I have a bit experience. You give me the toughest one.
I'll give you the toughest one. Okay, I really admire your courage. Okay. Toastmaster Munish, adversity is an opportunity. Adversity is an opportunity. Toastmaster Munish.
Good evening, everybody. Adversity is an opportunity. To be honest with you, long ago, I had a fear in my mind that adversity, at the time of any time adversity, I used to panic a lot. But with the time, with the age, with the experience, I've learned. Whenever there is an adversity, you learn something new. You grow with that. If there is no adversity, life is very boring. If 10 days, you have no problem, no hitch, no technical glitch, you'll feel that life, there is nothing is there. There should be something in life that makes life boring. And if you want to make your life energetic, nice, great, for that, adversity is very important. The people, those have risen in life, they have only one quality. They failed many times at the time of adversity, but they never gave up. They kept on trying that thing. And one day, they have achieved something. They have become something. They have made their name. I saw the movie of Dhoni. How many times he failed in that movie? Time he was, and he learned, but he didn't give up. He kept on trying. He was upset also, but one day he got a name. He became a cricketer. The same I saw of Sachin Tendulkar documentary movie. In that movie also, how many times he was failed, but he became successful. First time when Amitabh Bachchan went that he wants to become an actor, they said, what that height you have, you are not fit for this thing. But now that height and the voice, which was rejected by the people of Air India, Air Radio, but because of that, he has a name. He has a fame. So adversity always gives you an opportunity. If you want to rise in life, that is the only mantra of success. Thank you. Over to the Toastmaster, please.
Okay, Monish, you really spoke well. Okay, now my only feedback to you, see, you gave some 2-3 examples about Dhoni, Sachin, and I think Amitabh Bachchan, right? My suggestion is just stick to one example. Just tell the audience what is the adversity you faced. That had to come out. Okay, for instance, you can say Amitabh Bachchan, he had been to All India Radio. He gave audition test. He was declared failure. He had a very good voice, but that was declared a failure. He did not give it up. He took it as an opportunity. He came to India. Just elaborate that story or just give a story from your own life. That should be enough. Very well. Well, good, Monish. Okay. Yes, can we have the next speaker?
Hello, sir. This is Lakshmi. I would like to participate.
Yes, Lakshmi. What is your length of experience in Toastmasters?
I joined Toastmasters in 2019 and okay. I was there for 6 months. And in 2020, I took a break and I have just joined now, just 2 days back.
Okay, so I will give you a level 2 subject, Lakshmi. Okay.
Okay.
Toastmaster Lakshmi, it is the will, not the skill. It is the will, not the skill, Toastmaster Lakshmi.
It is the will, not the skill. I think willpower is a very positive thing and it comes from inside. We have to cultivate it. If we don't have the willpower, I think we should be mentally very strong to have the willpower. and we have to cultivate it. It doesn't come right from the beginning. And of course, but I don't agree that willpower is everything and skill is not anything. We should have the skill, and we should have the willpower to enable the skill to develop so that we progress in life. If we have a specific skill, for example, if I'm a good singer, I should work hard on it so that, and I should have the willpower to attain some goal on that singing. For example, if I want to become a very good singer, I have to become a professional. I should work hard on it. I should work hard on my skill. I should have the willpower. If I'm not mentally strong, if I easily give up, if I see others coming up and I give up at some point of time, then I will not reach heights. So I think skill and willpower both go hand in hand. Yes, that's it. Thank you.
Lakshmi, I think that is a very good attempt. You know, I really appreciate it. But Lakshmi, again, as I told you, the fundamental point, your speech was more like a preaching. You know, you must have this. But as I said, give a substantial story in your subject. Speak something about yourself or about any character. Yes?
There's some disturbance. No, I'm not speaking. There's some other disturbance.
No, go ahead.
Yeah.
Go ahead, Subho.
What I would have liked in a speech, you know, you give you some incident, some story for it. For instance, had I been there, I would have compared between Sachin Tendulkar and Kambli. Okay, both have got the talent, both have got the skills. But one man succeeded, the other couldn't. And one man succeeded because he had the willpower. So just give some substantial, you know, your proof of your point. Instead of rather again going around the bush, it is a will. I mean, people, audience knows it. Just speak on it. Just give a substantial story to it. Got it?
Okay, yeah. I'll keep in mind.
Yes, very good.
Yeah,
then we have the next speaker.
I raise my hand.
Yes, but can
you see? I'm Jayanti Shah.
Yes, Jayanti Shah. Okay, sir, how long you have been in Toastmasters?
Oh, 4 years.
So you are a veteran. You have taken part in any contest?
Yeah, many times.
Very good. Okay.
Don't give me number two, number three. Don't give the third one. The one and two, I'll be very able to do it.
I'll get the third one, you know. Okay. I came, I saw, I lost. I came,
oh. I saw, and I lost.
I lost.
Yeah. Toastmaster and friends. And now you all have a good evening, but I have a good morning. I am speaking from New York, New Jersey. So you will have a little different. I came, I saw, and I conquer. Is it so? Yeah. I came, and when I just was in New York and New Jersey, I would never know maybe I will be in this country. But once I had been here, this country, I decided I must have a green card. And the way in which I have acquired a green card is something which uniquely work well. And not me, but whole my family. I, as a pharmacist, applied on the basis of my pharmaceutical knowledge, and they needed pharmacy, and they accepted my application. And I think it took a little longer time by me to come to here, the USA. But I saw it. It is opportunity, and I acquire. Not only I acquire, but it is a great benefit to my family members. Because why? They are all my 10 family members able to come here, explore the opportunity. The opportunity gave them so much good life, which I would not have been given in India. And that is what I say. I saw, I came here, and I conquered. And that is a long way. My son has changed his lifestyle also, which I would not have been given in India. He is going for skiing in this winter, in very hard winter. Because how you are managing? Oh, I am getting up. I am doing up so nicely. I am skiing. Not only my son is doing up, but my grandson, 10 years old, going in the cold season of -18 degree. Can you believe it? He can do it. I never thought of. I saw it, this is a great opportunity which I got through. And I got my green card, and my son and my grand is the citizen of this country of USA. Over to you.
Okay, good, Jayant Shah. I just want to know from the audience, what was the subject given?
I saw, I came, and I conquered.
I lost. See, that was a subject, right? And what did he speak? He speak as I came, I saw, I conquered, right?
So I conquered, right. Yes.
That was not the subject.
So the last part I just made out, I would have been
saying. That's what I'm saying. So that's exactly what I'm saying. Understand the subject given to you. The subject is not what Shakespeare said, the opposite of what Shakespeare said. But what you could have said, you can very well give the same stories what you speak, but you have to deny it. You should say the right, I don't agree. The topic given to me, I came, I saw, I lost, is something which I don't agree at all. Make that stand clear.
And I agree. I should have gone the reverse way.
Yes. See, that is a twist normally happens in a contest.
I forgot to tell. Yeah.
See, some judges will note you have the specific point is lost, right? So it has to be absolutely tie up with the subject. If you have got the liberty to accept the subject or reject it. Is honesty the best policy? You can say, no, honesty is not the best policy. But you have to make that stand clear to the audience, right?
Right. So now, last point I missed out. Right. That's totally, thanks for correction.
That is what happens in a contest. Okay.
I'm meant for learning. I joined because of my learning.
Thank you so much. Yes, Vivek, can we have the next speaker?
Yeah, next speaker we have Prathamesh Bhare, who had raised his hand. Prathamesh.
Yes, Prathamesh. Can you put him in the spotlight because I cannot be able to see him?
Yeah.
Is it possible?
Yeah.
Prathamesh, yes. Yes.
Am I audible?
Yes, audible. Prathamesh, just tell your experience in Toastmasters.
Around 2 years.
2 years?
Yeah.
2 years, right? Okay. So I'll give you a level 2 of subject, okay? The only thing you have to fear is the fear itself. The only thing you have to fear is the fear itself. Toastmaster Prathamesh.
We are at a public speaking platform. And on a public speaking platform, fear is not an unknown subject. Crippling anxiety, something happening in our stomach, hands sweaty, knees shaking. We are all familiar with that feeling. Fear. I faced that too. There was a time in my life where I faced crippling fear. I could not speak a word in front of people. There was a time in my life, I was standing in front of my class. I could not utter a word in front of people. My other teammates were giving presentation after presentation. I couldn't speak a word. But then I heard this legend of Demosthenes, who went ahead and gave presentation after presentation, speech after speech, beating his fear, rising up in Athens, even though he was crippled, even though he had bad lungs, even though he was weakest among weak. And I found a platform of Toastmasters. Just hearing his bravery, I was able to conquer my fear. Just by looking at his legend. Looking at the legend of Demosthenes, that Athenian great orator. Why? Because I was able to conquer just my fear. So the only thing that stops us is our fear sometimes. Only thing to fear is fear itself. Over to you, Toastmaster.
Yes, Prathamesh, I think you nailed it. You spoke very well. There were some incidents, you gave a story of Demosthenes, What differentiates a good speaker and a better speaker and an average speaker is that, you may have all the essential of a good tabletop speech, But the differentiating factor should be, it could be more dramatic. Okay, create a scene where a Demosthenes is speaking. Maybe in the first 2-3 seconds, you can just remain silent. No, shows your panic. And then speak in a very dramatic manner. You bring some additional factors, or maybe can you humor. If you're good in humor, sprinkle it with humor. These are the differentiating factors. So you had the basics right, absolutely no problem. You spoke on the subject well. Structure was also okay, the story was okay. But now, if you want to really win, outbid others, there should be a differentiating factor. So that is where the practice comes into play. That is where the additional X factor comes into play. Well done. Yes, can we go ahead?
Yeah, so I don't know whether distinguished Toastmaster Santosh or Akshay raised their hands. So I leave it amongst them to say who came first. Akshay?
I raise hand.
So I will spotlight Santosh.
Okay. Okay.
You don't have to ask a question how long he is. I have given his introduction. He is distinguished Toastmaster.
I know Santosh very well. Okay. Toastmaster Santosh, if not today, Toastmaster Santosh.
Every day, I thought that I'll be exercising from tomorrow. But I have never thought, what if I start exercising today? And to go further, what if I start exercising right now? Table Topics Master and fellow Toastmasters, we quite often think that things happen to us and we start taking an action and going further to go and do something tomorrow or maybe whenever we want. However, there is no better time than now. And that is the power of now. We have recently celebrated our Republic Day. And that was an event which is of national interest. And today we are a country with Independence and Republic Day only because some leaders like Mahatma Gandhi have thought that this is the time, today is the moment that we are going to take an action and fight for our independence. So my dear friends, whatever you want to do, maybe giving an exam, maybe attempting a table topic after me, or maybe going and proposing a girl or expressing your love to the loved ones, just act immediately, because the power of now and the power of acting today and immediately is very, very, very important. Thank you so much, and over to the Table Topics Master.
Thanks, sir. Good, Santosh. You know, you have demonstrated this well. He understood the subject. This is a very short phrase. You know, the meaning is, tomorrow never comes. You know, you act, we interpret very correctly. My suggestion is to veterans, you know, people who are veterans, you know, normally all speakers will speak in the same fashion. If you want to have a differentiating factor, speak against it. Okay, it's very difficult, but then you have to substantiate it. If this subject is given to me, this is a Kashmiri saying, right? Everyone will speak only on the same way. But if you want to differentiate it, you say, give Mark Twain's quote, what you can do tomorrow, do day after tomorrow. See the opposite and take a stand. You will crack it. And of course, you will create a lot of humor. That is a winning speech. Yours is a very good speech. But a winning speech is something which outbeats others. You got my point? That is the idea. Yes, Santosh. This is for veterans and not for freshers. Freshers, you speak like this. But for veterans, if you want to beat the normal formula, do something exactly unexpected. Yes, Ravi.
Yeah, we have Akshay. I'm going to spotlight Akshay Singh.
Yes, Akshay.
Hello.
Yes, Akshay needs no introduction. You know, I think he's also a veteran, right? values or valuables? Values or valuables, Toastmaster Akshay?
Good evening, everyone. You know, the most precious thing for me is my spectacles, nor the values which I can look into your mind, nor the ethics which people say are out around us. When I am walking on the road, it is not the value that I have to walk on the side of the road. It is my spectacles that helps me to clear the path and have a visible direction. So my dear friends, for me, it is always the valuables. Values, maybe, but if I have to share my perspective, then valuables are more important. In my life, without my spectacles, I am a blind person. My number is so high that if I am removing this, I can only see black and white pixels on my screen. With this gives me a new perspective and adds colors to my life. Who would not want to live a colorful life? Values only hurts inside, but valuables, if they are not around, you are a handicapped person. If you can move forward, if you can live a colorful life, you need these valuable things. For me, it was my spectacles. For you, it can be your favorite bicycle, favorite car, maybe the favorite person. Even people in our life are our valuable possessions. Do not agree otherwise. If someone says it is not valuable, it is, because we can value people and these people can become our valuable possessions. So moving forward, remember, values may be something which you want to incorporate or put into perspective or share with others, but valuables are the things which you will cherish for long and you always want them. So look forward to the day when you have the maximum amount of valuable things so that you can think about the values rather than something other than that. So my dear friends, I'm keeping my specs on to see you all smiling because I value the enjoyment which we all are going to create together. So always remember to wear your spectacles or keep your valuable items close to you. Over to you, Toastmaster.
Good, good, Akshay. I think you also spoke well. You understood the subject, okay? What you would have done is just established why you consider your specs the most valuable. You can see that it affects your eyesight, okay? If this subject is given to me, you know what I would say? In a city like Bombay, when you're driving in a car, when you're going to your office in the middle of the traffic in the morning hour, I don't care for honesty. I don't care for courtesy. I will simply yell at my fellow drivers that because my valuable is my car. Say something like this, where you can connect with the audience. Establish an anecdote, okay? Because this happens on a daily basis. Okay, see, it may be true, or you can take the other view also. It is up to you where you are good at it, okay? And one more point I want to share with you. When I was the Toastmaster, right? I said, now if for the same subject, I will repeat it in a different tone. Values or valuables? See here, if I say values or valuables is a metaphor, that means your honesty is a valuable thing. Sincerity is a valuable thing. But the way I said in the beginning was values or, then it becomes a choice. You understood? So that is where listen to the Toastmaster. What is he trying to say? If you understood or if there is a confusion, clear it in your speech. My understanding is that you are giving me an option between values or valuable. Show your hand. Something like this. Got my point? Yes.
Yes.
Do we have time for how many speakers we can line up now?
We will have two more. We have Dibyendra Jyoti Das who had raised his hand, and one more we will go.
Okay. So you let me know when to stop the practical demonstration.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. Akshay, a word of caution, you took 2 minutes and 33 seconds.
Yeah.
So okay. Thanks. Yeah, I thought I overshot because I was not able to see the card.
Yes. Yes. Who is the speaker now? Dibyendra Jyoti Das, right?
Right.
Das, how long have you been in Toastmasters?
It's been 4 months.
So I will give a very simple subject to you. Very, very, see, the simple subject doesn't mean you can say anything. You have to speak in a structured manner. Okay, you know the tagline, you know the subject story also, but try to make it in a structured manner. Okay, Toastmaster Das, what makes you happy? What makes you happy, Toastmaster Das?
When my room is completely untidy, I don't do anything. I just wait and I try to make it more untidy. Time passes by, my mom comes in, sees what's there, and I make it more untidy. At the end of 3-4 days, she would come in and she would make it tidy again. What makes me happy is getting work done by others. Well, it's very easy to do it myself. I can do all the work around me by myself, but what makes me happy is getting the work done by the people around me. This goes on almost everywhere. One day, there were some problems in the nearby park. There was a wire which was hanging and it was dangerous. I could have done it myself, but you know my style. I want to see myself happy if I get work done by others. I went to the wire and was about to touch it. And I acted as if I got electrocuted. People came around me. They tried to help me and I was acting profuse. And then they thought, this is not something good. This might be bad for the others. So they came together and they did something and finally it was fixed. I love to see people work for a particular thing and get work done. That's what makes me happy. Similarly, whatever makes you happy is what you should pursue. So go ahead, make yourself happy in whatever way you want. And over to you, Toastmaster Sue.
Das really spoke well, you know. It did not talk as if you had done, spend only 4 months in Toastmasters, you know. You had, the speech had all the good elements, you know. It's a question of time and practice, you know. I'm sure you have a long way to go, you will do very well. Yes.
Thank you.
We have a last question now.
Anyone, last speech? So, Boo, any suggestions? Mr. Das is asking for it.
No, he has done well for his level 4 months. I don't want to give any suggestion. It's a question of practice. Right? It's just a question of practice.
Last person for the evening, anyone?
What is the time now, Vivek?
It's 6 minutes to 10 p.m.
Okay, so we have 6 more minutes, right?
Yeah.
So how should we need to have any Q&A session or shall we have a speaker?
Yeah, so we'll have a Q&A session now. I thought you will have closing comments as well in the last 5 minutes. So let's have a Q&A session.
We can take only 2 key questions, 2 important questions.
Okay. Yeah.
Any 2 important questions. See, you can always connect with me offline. My number is known to you. You can take from all these organizers. Anybody can connect with me offline, no problem. No questions?
I have a question. Arpit here.
Oh?
Arpit, go ahead.
Yes,
Arpit. I have a question.
Yes,
question is, when we're giving table topics, the fear anyone has in their mind is, what if I fail? What if, what will people think of me? I will look stupid. How to get over that fear while we're attempting a table topic?
See, at least let me assure you, in your Toastmaster session, be it at club level, either level, no one will have that kind of opinion about you. Even if you go to the stage, just stand there. Okay, they'll give you an applause. Okay, I have not come across any Toastmaster where you are ridiculed. So please get this fear once and for all. Okay, if you are going to take part in the first time, not try to attempt it in a club level. Okay, practice, maybe participate maybe for 3-4 months. You will overcome that fear. Okay, and my second, even if some people cracks joke behind you, it has happened to me, just ignore it. The fact that you could speak in front of an audience is something commendable. Okay, and the fact that you can speak even rubbish is more commendable than the people who crack jokes on you. Just don't bother about it. Okay. It happened to me. I contested in an evaluation contest. You know, I was just walking on the stage up and down. Some people cracked. Okay, they cracked jokes about me because I was not knowing it. It didn't matter. But the same person in the next contest, you know, he saw me make very good improvement. He appreciated me. So don't bother it. It's a question of time. Yes. Okay. My closing comments is, you know, as I said, measure where you stand on a degree of, say, on a scale of 1 to 10, you evaluate yourself, are you at level 2, level 3, or level 8, you know, and try to increase incrementally, be 1 point or 2 points, that is enough. That is how you will progress it. The idea is not to win, the idea is not to become a table tennis champion, that is supplementary. Just make sure that you're progressing well year after year. I'm sure everybody has got more opportunities and they will all progress very well. And I think I'll thank Vivek and the organizers for having given me this opportunity. And so my number is known to all of you. You can always approach me. And I think with this, I'll hand over the stage back to Vivek. Thank you so much.
Wow. We had such a wonderful 1 hour. In fact, I was a timer and still I didn't notice the time at all because that's how interesting Subbu made all of us. We did have a lot of lessons. My only worry here is that when we conduct the area contest, the question paper is already out. So Subbu has actually released all the questions already. It's a word of caution for the participants now that all the others are going to know what the title of the table topic contest is going to be. Best wishes to all of you. Life is full of table topics, and Subbu has extended his advice to all of us, not just for the contest, I think even for our real life situations. Thank you, Subbu. Good night to all of you. Thank you for joining in. Let's meet once again in the next Wednesday Wisdom. Until then, goodbye. Bon Pidi. Bye-bye.
Thank you.
Nice, Vivek. Thank you all the way.
Thank you.
Thank you. Bye-bye.
Thank you.
Yeah, good way conducting. And it's a gave the